The power of storytelling has always been at the forefront of what we do. Shaping our narrative starts with who is behind the lens. Before film, before TV, there was the still image. Strong Black Lead brought more than a dozen photographers, image makers, moment creators from different corners of the storytelling universe to talk about the unique ways we shape our narratives and craft our legacies. This is Strong Black Lens. Our photos. These keepsakes are the time capsules we need, the evidence we have that our people are resilient. Even through many adversities, we still had these moments of celebration. Whether it was our first cars, our first road trips with friends, dinner, or even purchasing property, we did that. And holding the beginning of our legacy close to us is a must.
Most of our imagery is in the Black home, sitting on our own coffee tables, because we documented our
own history. That's the most important thing. I think of like, the most important photographers for me are the photo enthusiasts, the moms and dads going to the 1982 Johnson family reunion. I need to see what the fish fry at church look like. Those intimate moments.
Yeah. The most important images that I should be taking should be the ones of my family. As I think more about legacy and Black legacy and the Black core family, and how lucky some families are to have a photographer in them. I feel like it's my responsibility not only to tell the story of the Black people as a whole or my experience, but like my family.
As soon as I got this camera, I felt like the world was in my hands, and I would just make little documentaries with my friends. Me and my family, during the holidays, we would make Christmas videos, and it was all about documenting moments and preserving family history.
There's a part of photography where you almost validate your existence or the vision that you have in front of you, whatever your reality is, what your neighborhood's like, what your family looks like. That's where I think it becomes more important, because there's almost a fight to prove that we exist. I think in a lot of other areas, white people take photos and that's fine. I don't think they're ever in a space of having to validate that they existed. So for us, it becomes almost revolutionary to create these images. You know, it's the audacity to exist. We have the responsibility to make sure that people know that we exist, that we live normal lives, we have families, we have love, we have hurt, we have all the pains and the things that go through as we go through as humans. We are humanizing ourselves, even if society doesn't really care to acknowledge us.
When white people have been the ones that have controlled the narrative about what Black is, what Black identity is, who Black people are for the entirety of our existence, when it comes to photography and when it comes to like so many levels of who we are as people and what other people think of us, non-Black people think of us, because you have a lot of white photographers that have made a lot of money off of photographing Black people.
That's so interesting, because the economy around the visual image making practice, no one wants to talk about.
Right.
And you hit on that. And I always have this argument with my agents, and ever since I've been coming up and doing this for so many years. And it's scary, because you hit it on that, you know, when I went to New York and I would show my work around, you know, if I had 5 Black people in my portfolio, I wasn't getting hired. It's just so strange how it's flipped now. We're artists and we can do anything.
Well, it's like, you know, photography is a weird one, because, you know, anyone can pick up a camera and take images. It's really about how we see and how we perceive things, or how we perceive the world. So it's about a way of seeing. So the eye is really about what you want to portray, your narrative, or what vision you're trying to put out into the world. And we all come from different backgrounds, so we have these different experiences. So when you're behind the lens and you're capturing a moment, or you're capturing a person, or you're trying to create a situation and you're trying to get that on film, all that stuff is there and how you see it when you click the button. When you click that shutter, that comes from you. That's that moment when you feel it's just a decisive moment, some people call it. But I call it, it's a soulful moment for me, I think. It's just more about, it's guttural.
I feel like photography is literally the foundation of history. At different points in my life, there have been different images that have like changed the trajectory of my career. But there are also photos I've taken that are just really important to me. And I feel like we know things exist. We know things have happened because we've seen it in photos. It solidifies to me our very existence. I feel like everybody should be able to document their own story and tell their perspective and explain what's happening to them and in the world.
So I grew up in an atmosphere that was always full of photographs. You know, there was family photo albums that was center stage in the household, and there was always a wide range of photography books. So before I actually physically picked up the camera, I was actually just looking at the family photo albums that gave me insight into the power of photography and the importance of documenting the family.
When I picked up a camera, I kind of realized that this was, you know, this could be my tool. This could be really my way of kind of expressing myself, of kind of commenting on the world.
You know, for so many years, we were not in charge of our visual representation. Mm-hmm. So now we have through digital medium, through social media, we can do that. So for me, I think it's all about changing the narrative. And that's why we're here today.
Like you said, we didn't control our narrative for so long. You know, finding out that some of these images that were taken of our ancestors, you know, some of these images are fake. They're not, you know, they hire models to model, to create these narratives around our community to project, you know, hyper Black masculinity, the Black brute to the rest of the world. Right. So people were scared of us, you know, photographing children in zoos.
I studied the works of W.E.B. Du Bois. And his idea for the creation of the Negro exhibit that he would bring to Paris in 1900. And the idea behind that was based on using images that represent pride and dignity within the Black community and show a larger world to offer a counter narrative to the negative stereotypical images that we were accustomed to seeing.
We have to deal with 10 times as much hassle to get in the room to shoot. And finally, we're in a situation now where they can pinpoint and say, oh, we have somebody documenting a president or a vice president or a governor, and they're Black. And their work speaks. And finally, we are able to tell our own story, like, oh, Africa is not some shit slum hole, or it's not a place of poverty, it's not a place of lions and zebras running all over the place, you know. And that, to me, is extremely powerful because it gives people hope.
Yeah, it's absolutely necessary.
Right.
Like, as a queer person, I know that growing up, imagery, especially of Black queer men or Black queer anything, like, it was very scarce. For me, it's a lot about mending trauma. Growing up, I didn't see me represented virtually anywhere. I mean, there are pockets of it. You would search for that. You would search for something that looks like yourself or behaves like you as a sense of comfort, and you can't find that anywhere. I remember I had a cousin, and I would go over to their house, and they had a very large photo of Prince. And Prince being Prince in that. And I remember just staring at that. I'm like, why do I connect to this? Why do I connect with this person who is moving their body in such a way? And then I couldn't find that virtually anywhere else. So today I feel certainly a responsibility to provide imagery and provide feelings for people who are coming up who didn't have that. Because if I did, it would have saved me a lot of heartache.
Yeah. It's the powerful global language of photography. Unlike any other language besides art itself, it transcends the four corners of the universe. I was about to get on the train, and I came upon this young brother about maybe 12, 13 years old. And I'm on one side of the gate. He's on the other side of the gate. And he's looking at me with this look. And it seems like when you see the picture, you would think it's in a jail. But his eyes is piercing. They're looking at me almost like saying, help me. And that image haunted me because we just met for a short period in time, and he's looking at me in this bar, almost like he's trying to escape this world. So I'm haunted by the image. I was able to capture that image, but it stays with me to this day. And it served as a reminder of my duty and responsibility, not only really as a photographer, but as one who's trying to make a powerful difference in the community, that there's young men out there and women that need guidance.
my granny passed away a few years ago. Thank you. And just going through her photo albums and seeing like all these family members that I don't know who they are, and seeing her like in her heyday with her cigarette, you know, the edge of the plastic couch.
A couple months before my granny died, she let me finally take her portrait. And, you know, she was always like, why don't you get a job at the post office? You know, like, what are you doing out there? You know, like, you need to make some money. The bank is hiring. The best part of, like, me becoming successful was her to see that and for her to finally trust me to take her portrait.
When someone passes away, which we hope they don't, but they will, you go, wow, that's something. It's a time marker, the time stamp. I'm very honored to have those type of images in my portfolio.
This is the power of imagery. This is the power of being able to have a perspective that can lead someone to feel something.
We were the documentarians and we were the authors of our own stories then, at least. And now I feel like publicly we're being acknowledged for that instead of it just being, you know, this is for when people come over and we pull out the plastic album and shit. Yes. and stuff.
You said what you said.
From weddings to the first day of school, the human experience captured through photography has served as a time capsule. Not only do we love a good story, we are the best at telling our own stories.
Black skin is not harder to light than white skin. It's just that people haven't taken the time and effort.
It's definitely a cop-out.
Something that I take pride in is making sure my people are good.
There is no excuse for bad imagery.
As a queer Black person in this country, I didn't see me represented anywhere.
James inspired me in a way that usually only Spike does.
Being a person of color who has a lens is really, really empowering.